So you want to insulate your garage, but you're not sure if you should use fiberglass, cellulose, or spray foam. Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about the best types of insulation that you should use to insulate your garage. We're going to talk about fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam. Before we dive into this, please go below and hit that like button for us. Thanks. So the first thing we're going to talk about is fiberglass. Now, fiberglass can be a good enough option. It's readily available and it's relatively low cost. However, there are some downsides that come with fiberglass. As we've talked about before, fiberglass does not establish an air seal. Not only that, but you will have to replace it over the years because it will break down. And the other thing, especially if you're looking at a garage, keep in mind that fibrous material can cling onto odors and moisture and that sort of thing. And your garage typically can be an area that has a lot of different odors and possibly fumes moving around in the air. That fiberglass can hold on to that. That could cause issues down the road, or at the very least may push you to replace it a little bit sooner. So can fiberglass be used as a good enough option? Absolutely. But just some things to keep in mind. So the next option we're going to discuss is cellulose. Now for this, typically if we're looking at the walls of the garage, we're going to be looking at some type of new wool cellulose bat that we can put up on the walls easily. Now again, this can be a good option for your garage. This would be a better option than fiberglass for a couple reasons. It does act as a better insulation, has a higher R value, does resist thermal transfer a little bit better. Doesn't quite establish that air seal, so we still have that con that goes against it, but it does hold up longer, so it's more durable than fiberglass. So again, we are stepping up a little bit. Of course, with that, we do get a bit of a bump up in cost, but if your budget can't afford it, keep in mind that cellulose could be another option just to give a little bit more longevity, give a little bit more performance to that garage area that you're working on. So lastly, we are going to talk about spray foam as an option to insulate that garage. Now, spray foam will obviously be the best answer. Now, let's get the only con for spray foam out of the way, and of course, that's the cost. Spray foam will be the most expensive option that you're looking at. Well, what comes with that cost? Its performance is much higher than the fiberglass and cellulose that we've talked about. It will last as long as that building is standing, and it establishes that air seal, which is a crucial point to remember. If we're looking at a garage, this is somewhere that has a huge door that's going to be opening and closing. When that's closed, you want to make sure the rest of that area is sealed up as much as possible. So that air seal is going to be crucial. That longevity is going to be there. And of course, the effectiveness is just being a good thermoresistive property. Spray foam is obviously going to be the best answer. Keep in mind, it will be the most expensive. So we've looked at a few options to insulate that garage. We've given you a good, better, best situation in this, where fiberglass can be a good enough option. Cellulose is a step up, gives you better performance, and spray foam will give you the absolute best performance and longevity out of these options. It really is going to be up to you, your priorities, your budget, that determine which one of these options is best for you and your garage. If you want to learn more about the best insulation to use for your garage, check out the link in the description below. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.